Hello there. In this video, I'm going to talk about the difference between recursion and iteration. So I'm just going to show you an example of and oppose them so you can see the difference. Let me just start right away. In order to do so, I'm going to write a small program and we're going to compare functions that do both. Go. There we go. Package main. Func main. So let's start with this. Let's say I would like to get the result of this calculation. 0 plus 1 plus 2. 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8 plus 9 plus 10, this gets and so on. I want the sum of those numbers. So I want to see it. Println result 1. So this will be one way, not the most efficient one. Let's check it. Let's check the result. Let's go. 55. So now, let's say I want a function to do that, depending on the until which number I go. So let's go back there. And this function is going to be iterative, doing the same calculation with iteration. So iterative calculation, and it's going to take an index. So the index is going to be the number of numbers of the sum, and return the result. So, the first thing you would do, as you can see, is probably a loop at this point. You do a for. You need somewhere to store the result first. Result, initialize it to 0. For I equal 0. Till I is inferior to the index plus 1, I guess, in this case, and I plus plus. So, in order to do this operation, what we need is the result equal the result plus the I. This does the same for number 10. So we return the result in the end. Good spacing, let me fix that. And there you go. So if we call this function, result number 2 be equal to the call of this function iterative calculation of index 10, because I'm going to print it f the result, the iterative function is back value and result number 2. Let's see if we get exactly the same result. as a privilege operation. Run code test. 55 and 55. So this works. This is equivalent to doing this 10 times. Let's say I wanted 11 plus 12 plus 13. Here, the only thing I need to change here is the number. So let's compare it again. Right. Same number. So now, this is the iterative way to do it with a for. So now, we want to have the same result, but with recursion. And recursion is pretty much a function that calls itself. So how do we do that? So we're going to need another function. First of all. And recur, let's call it recursive calculation. Still need the index, int, which will be the same, int to return. So now, as I said, we have to use a function to call itself. So no for, you only get to use if. So in this case, we do not need to store the result, and you have to have a condition that stops the calling of the function itself. It's hard to explain this way, but let me just show you the example. If index equal 1, then we return 1. This will be the stoppage. I'm assuming that all the index will be either 0 or positive. Now, if index is superior to 1, then this is the interesting part. You return the index, in this case, plus the recalling of the function again with the index minus 1, and this will call the function many times as the index is not equal to 1. When it's equal to 1, it goes into the first if, so this returns 1 and stop the calling of the function, and then everything else return 0, because that's the way go format wants it. So this should work technically. Let's do result number 3 and let's compare it. So recursive calculation of what we said. Let's put 13. Actually do it quicker, I'm just gonna copy. There we go. Result number 3. It's the recursive function. And this should do it. Let's compare both. I mean the 3 of them. So control L to test. Oh, let me put a backslash N here so it's clearer. Sorry. There we go. So I've just shown you the way to do an iterative calculation and a recursive calculation, and you can this way compare both of them. You get the same result, except that one is loop and the other one is calling itself. So it's the multiple calls that of itself that actually do the loop. I'll let you watch this example again and see how you can apply it to some of the exercises that you will have to do. That's it for now, and thank you for watching again.